The Rise Guys.
Outrageous Morning Radio.
On 93.3, The Planet.
It's Thursday, October 22nd.
We're coming up on Halloween. We're coming up on my favorite time of year, man. Just all the way around.
Fall.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, you used to call it fat guy weather. Still can.
Still fat guy weather. Yeah. Today is, to me, equally as important because today is the third annual Monster Spelling Bee.
Oh, yes. Yes, it is.
That's going to be fantastic. If you've never heard the Monster Spelling Bee in the past, blam. I'm going to tell you, it is, it's fun. Any spelling bee is fun, unless it's really smart people. And I'm not saying that our monsters are not smart. Don't get me wrong. But I'm saying if you're watching, like, the Scripps Spelling Bee on ESPN, you know, there's not a whole lot of fun there. Except every once in a while, one of the kids' eyes will bug out like Barbara Bush because they don't know the word. And that's kind of interesting. But most of the time, it's just kind of like, oh, yeah, spell, you know.
Cheese.
Yeah, shut
that
up.
That was your word.
That was my word.
Macabre.
M-C-O-B.
Right.
That is incorrect.
Yeah. There's that noise again. So the Monster Spelling Bee today, and that is, we'll start that off talking to R.A. Mihailoff. He was Leatherface in the movie Texas Chainsaw Massacre. We developed a little bit of a friendship with R.A. over the years, and he's going to be back in with us this year, bringing his friends with him, Freddy Krueger. Now, these guys aren't the real ones. I'm going to point that out.
Yes.
It's not real Robert Englund. But,
no, but he probably would, given the opportunity.
Sure he would, yeah. So it'll be Leatherface versus Freddy versus Otis from Devil's Rejects versus Pinhead.
Yep.
In a Monster Spelling Bee. And it's a whole lot of fun. It's a whole lot of fun.
We look forward to it every year.
Yeah. Then the Monster Spelling Bee will happen. Freaking Leatherface himself.
Yes.
From Texas Chainsaw Massacre. R.A. Mihailoff, the guy behind the Leatherface.
Yeah.
Carrying the chainsaw will be in this very studio along with Freddy and Pinhead. And Ralph, oh, not Ralph, what is Ralph?
Ralph.
Otis.
Otis, yeah.
Ralph.
Ralph Cramden.
Yeah.
He's a ghost.
To the moon. All right, we'll take a break and be back.
Headlines, yes. Harley, for the holidays, Monster Spelling Bee.
That's right. Very good.
All hail the saviors of upstate morning radio.
The Rise Guys Morning Show, 93.3, The Planet.
Rise Guys Morning Show. Good morning to you. It is 8:13. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. Every year, it's always what we call Radio Gold. It's two different things. One, oh Lord. So let me describe what I'm seeing. Freddy Krueger just walked in here in full regalia, and then there's, oh Lord, there's Pinhead. He's pointing at me, and he's got the box in his hand. Oh, no. Don't open the box now.
No, don't do it.
And then there's R.A. Mihailoff, the legend of horror with, from, oh, man, he's laying the box in front of me. Holy cow. I don't know what that's about. I'm not going to open it.
Don't do it.
R.A. Mihailoff, of course, Leatherface from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Have a seat right there. Sorry, no one told you. Right there. Yes, sir. Perfect. Thank you, sir. Yeah, that microphone is yours, and then that one, Otis from Devil's Rejects, that's your microphone.
How you doing, Mattman?
Good, how are you,
doing
Otis?
Doing good. Yeah,
it's good to see you. None of y'all look any different. It's like we just paused time from last year. Everybody looks the same.
Good morning,
how are you? R.A., you doing all right?
Fantastic.
Good to see you, sir.
Glad to be back.
Actually, you've bulked up some.
A little bit. Yeah.
What you been doing?
I made my triumphant return to the Iron Arena, brother.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. I got lazy and took 3 years off just laying around.
Yeah.
Eating salami and capicola sandwiches.
Yeah.
That was enough. So I went back to California, went rejoined the world-famous Gold's Gym in North Hollywood, California, brother.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's one thing that we've learned from speaking with you over the years is that you started off in professional wrestling before you got into to horror movies. Or is it vice versa?
Backwards.
It's backwards.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, I used to have really long blonde hair, much like Otis.
Yeah.
And I would get stopped on the street all the time. Hey, are you a professional wrestler?
Yeah.
When I had my hair bleached blonde, I would buy gas at this one gas station, you know, at least once a week.
Uh-huh.
Finally, the kid came out one day and he says, "Hey, can I ask you a question?" I said, "Yeah, kid, what's that?" He goes, "Did you have your face surgically altered to look like Hulk Hogan?"
Wow! Wow! So now, you're back in the gym, powerlifting. You're all bulked up now. Have you actually returned to wrestling?
No. But you know, as I'm getting older, and that's just a fact of life. You know, every day there's a whole crop of young guys coming up behind me trying to take my jobs in the movies and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I got to do what I can to stay ahead of them. You know.
Yeah, I got you. I got you. So as you know from listening to the show, and earlier this morning we've talked about it, R.A. Mihailoff is, he was Leatherface in Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3. Every year I always ask you, you're still getting together with Kane and everybody and doing the conventions?
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, I mean, I've been booked every weekend since the third weekend of September, all over the country.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know, Kane and I get together whenever we can. You know, we have our ghost hunting group along with Rick McCollum.
Yeah. Kane Hodder, of course, was Jason Voorhees.
And
the 13th.
Yeah, played Jason more than anyone ever.
Yeah, yeah. So what is this, when you go to these conventions, and I mean, every city has one now. Like, we have one in the upstate called MonsterCon. I went to that. I loved it. I thought it was great. It was great just to, you know, go in and see all the products for sale, but just nobody goes to. I felt out of place because I just wore jeans and a t-shirt. People, it's like Halloween there, you know. They dress up. They got the cosplay stuff going on. And then you can meet some of the your favorite actors, actresses from TV shows and whatnot. When you do these, what is the strangest thing somebody's ever come up and asked you to sign?
Oh, I can tell you exactly what that is. Kane and I were at a convention, and toward the end of the, like, it was Sunday night, late in the day, toward the end of the convention.
Yeah.
A girl who'd been, you know, kind of like just hanging out all weekend long, came up and asked Kane and I to sign her shins.
Her shins.
Her shins.
Her shins.
Wow.
And then she went immediately to the tattoo booth and had our names tattooed on her shins.
Holy moly.
Which I thought was pretty hardcore.
Wow, that is cool. That is cool. Good looking girl?
It was a long convention.
Last time we were talking, I mean, and I think, not that you didn't have any self-esteem, but I think you were even amazed at how these young, hot chicks, like, I was Google image searching you yesterday, I think, and I saw all these hot young 20-somethings sitting there, arms all around you, taking pictures.
I love my job.
Oh, you have to, your job.
Yeah, yeah, that? I love my job.
What is that?
You know, I love my job.
Oh, you're, oh,
yeah,
my
I was
bad.
Being Swedish oh, for a minute. Oh, oh, yeah, yes. You know, I used to yes. know a guy from Sweden, and yeah, I love my job.
Oh, okay, I thought that was an acronym about yeah, girls
no,
or something.
No, yeah. I love my job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, if any of these girls, since you hang out with Kane, who was Kane Hodder, of course, Jason, and then you, Leatherface, or have any girls come up and say that would be the ultimate threesome?
I will not presume to speak for Kane.
Right. Because, well, yes, you're speaking for yourself only.
What was the question again?
let me change the wording of the question then. Have you ever had a young lady come up to you and say you would be one of, you would be someone that you, she would like to have a threesome with? With maybe another horror movie legend.
Oh, not a threesome.
No.
But
a foursome. Bring
no,
Freddy.
No. There's enough. No, there's. No, but I have had women come up to me and say, you know, I have a latex fetish.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then I've gone immediately to the costume shop and gotten a mask.
Yeah. Yeah. And I know last time we talked about that. It's weird because it seems with when we have RAN9, it always the questions always go to sex. And I remember the one time you said the girl wanted you to actually wear the mask.
Yeah, that's the, oh, I told you that story already?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's the one I was referring to.
It's legendary.
Yeah.
I think about that story.
I think about it, too.
It's legendary. Like, I've never had a girl say, hey, I want you to... Let's have sex. I don't want you to wear your headphones.
Yeah,
no one's
right.
ever said that.
Yeah.
It's a different thing. I mean, it's
yeah, I doubt so if too many. Yeah, I don't. I doubt if too many women have headphone fetishes.
Right. Yeah. You know?
Never met any that did.
No.
But there's women with latex fetishes, and then, I mean, Leatherface and Jason and.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure like chicks are all the time trying to get with Freddy. Look at
of
him
course.
Over there.
Freddy, you have to turn him away, don't you?
All the time. They got a glove fetish, Freddy. That's right.
Second base is nightmare.
Yeah. Oh, no, this is something cool. Yesterday, we were talking about you guys coming in. Nine has this thing that we had Ric Flair on. Speaking of wrestling, we had Ric Flair on a while back, and Nine asked Rick, who would be on the Mount Rushmore of wrestling? Of course, Rick talks a lot. He ended up naming about 12 dudes because you talk about the Funks and the Briscoes and the Dusties and everybody.
And the other Briscoe.
So yesterday, we kind of came up with this, the Mount Rushmore of horror movies. Now, and not, we're talking about the faces of,
mm-hmm.
right? Not
mm-hmm.
Stephen King, not, you know, the guy that just passed.
Wes Craven.
Wes Craven.
Yeah. None of those guys. No John Carpenter's,
yeah.
but the iconic faces, the masks.
We're talking the leather faces, the Freddies, the Jasons. Who do you think?
I think you've said three of them right there.
Okay.
Freddy,
yeah.
Jason,
yeah.
Michael Myers,
mm-hmm.
and Leatherface, of course.
And Leatherface, yeah.
So that would be the four.
Yeah. That was nine.
That was my list.
That was the one.
It's the most iconic list.
And doesn't Otis get a vote here? Come on.
Well, not, no.
I got a knife, and I'm right next to you.
No. but I'm armed and dangerous.
Yeah, and right. you got the chainsaw.
He's so, like ripped even more than he's ever been, so yeah. R.A. Mihailoff, Leatherface from Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3. Actually, the reason he's here and here every year is he's a part of Pinhead's Graveyard
mm-hmm.
Up in Canton, North Carolina. And, you know, the big attraction where you go and get your britches scared off. and then you can meet, that's the cool thing, too. You can meet the legend of the movie that, like, is there a Leatherface in?
Yeah.
Okay, so, I mean, that's pretty awesome right there, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's really cool. You can go be a part. What's the website?
It's pinedgegraveyard.com.
Oh, that's easy to remember.
Yeah.
Okay, very good. I'll write .com down. I'll know that one.
And it's all just horror movie characters.
Yeah.
Everything you see in the movies is out there.
Yeah.
And you should tell them it's new and expanded this year.
Oh, it is new and expanded.
Oh, it's expanded?
Yeah.
There's more.
Yeah. There is. Yeah. It's a whole lot longer, probably at least a good 30 minutes now. We've added a new character. We kind of shy away from non-horror movie characters, but we've got a new character in there that's a really neat setup and a big crystal lake now and just
oh, wow.
really... Really, it's the biggest it's ever been in 19 years. So.
What do you mean a non-horror movie? Like, are we going to see, like, Santa Claus
no,
in there
no,
killing
well,
people?
No, he's a horror character, but I can't relate him to a movie.
Oh,
you know?
I see.
Yeah. Because we've
well,
always...
you made up an original character.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
yeah.
pretty awesome, too.
Okay.
That's pretty awesome. Let me ask you this, Otis. We were talking about the Mount Rushmore of horror. And the reason I'm directing this toward you is because you're a character from Devil's Rejects and all those movies. You think Rob Zombie killed the character of Michael Myers? Is this just, you don't even look at it the same anymore, right?
You know, that I'm going to get a lot of hatred on this, but I actually like those two movies.
Really?
I watched the second one in the theater and I kind of walked away disappointed. And after I've watched it,
mm-hmm.
I kind of enjoy it now.
Yeah.
But it is not the Michael Myers that we all grew up with.
Right.
You know, it's a darker version.
Yeah.
Whenever he was grunting.
Mm-hmm.
And stabbing those people, I was like, what's going on?
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
and no Halloween music like in the second one.
Yeah.
And,
it was
and,
less is more. Michael Myers, as I said yesterday, had a very simplistic mask.
Oh.
He could stand at the end of a stairwell and just turn his head sideways, and it scared the crap out of you.
Yeah. Now, the flashback nightmare dream sequence thing, the beginning of the second
uh-huh.
Halloween Rob Zombie did,
yeah.
if the whole movie had been like that, I probably would have had a heart attack 45 minutes in,
yeah.
as would a lot of other people, but it would have been the most badass movie of all time, possibly.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then, it just kind of lets you down because you start out with that and like, oh man, this is intense. This is, whoa, what in the hell?
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, that was a dream and the real movie isn't going to be as exciting as that.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah. It's just not the same. R.A., what has happened to horror movies? You know, we'll get these franchises. You know, we had the Saw franchise, the Paranormal Activity. They've drained every drop of money out of that one. What's happened with that? Why is it not the same? Is it almost like rock music in that what else can you do with it?
Yeah, that could be part of it. I think also it's just the nature of the business now. Multi-level conglomerates have to squeeze every penny out of anything. It's easier for bean counters to crunch numbers.
Yeah.
Than it is for creative people to, get the financing they need.
Yeah.
And, it's just, and it's the multi-level, multi-platform venues, every kind of screen, phone screen, computer screen.
Yeah.
So they just want to maximize the money. That's why they squeeze everything out.
There's no iconic characters anymore. Like the ones we said would be on the Mount Rushmore. That's just gone.
Hopefully, keep your fingers crossed. That's just a cyclic downturn, and there'll be a new wave. Of iconic characters.
I hope so. Yeah. I like a good scary movie, but the stuff now, it just seems like it's made for teenagers. I went and saw The Visit. Did you hear that one? Okay, so it's about these two kids, and they go to visit their grandparents, and then they find out the grandparents are nuts, right?
Yeah, right.
Good plot, but you laughed. There was comedy in it. You laughed more than you just jumped, and it's like all horror movies now are written for teenage girls, it seems.
Well, that's the prized demographic, the 18 to 35 or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
So for some reason, they perceive that to be the biggest number of people that go to movies and also spend, discretionary income.
That's our number one demo.
Yeah, it is.
1834.
I love horror movies. Yeah. But we talked about how Rob Zombie Halloween movies didn't do the Michael Myers character any favors. It was probably worse for the other ones. Like when they did the Friday the 13th reboot and nobody cared because it was just not very good.
Yeah.
Because what was missing there was that element of humor that had been in the other ones. Mm-hmm. And they did the Nightmare on Elm Street with Jackie Earle Haley as Freddy. Just destroyed that character because the humor was gone from it. And the humor kind of lightened up the fact that you basically had an undead demon child molester haunting people's dreams.
Right. And as Nine pointed out yesterday, see what you guys think, horror movies now don't have nudity. You have to have nudity, yes?
Yes.
You have to have sex.
Yes.
I mean,
yes.
That's the somebody's going to get, a pitchfork through them.
Or an arrow or. Yeah.
You have to.
You got to.
You can't be PG-13.
No.
Never.
No.
Glad we're on the same wavelength on that. That's so true.
If you're not going to have boobs, you got to have enough blood to make up for the lack of it.
Yeah. I still think, no offense to the Texas Chainsaw Massacre franchise, but I think The Shining is still the absolute... I should try it sometime. I could not watch that movie alone at night, I don't think. It literally... And it's not even gore. I mean, there's a lot of, the blood coming out of the elevator and stuff, but it's just... It's the music, it's the way it's shot, everything about it is just eerie. What do you think? Is there one that, to you, R.A., being a legend of horror, that, I know you want to say Leatherface and Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but just off the cuff, a shoot, as they say in the business.
Yeah, right, yeah.
What's a movie that literally... It makes your skin crawl when you see it.
Well, Matt, I got to tell you something. It's going to be tough to do it right off the cuff because I've been asked to pick my top 10 horror films of all time.
Yeah.
And I've been stewing on this. It's been roiling in my mind for weeks.
Yeah.
And I'm having a terrible time picking 10.
Yeah.
Top 10. And I have to tell you, Night of the Living Dead.
That was my daddy's. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. Yeah.
The original Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Mm-hmm.
Todd Browning's Freaks.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
Oh.
I had to write this down. Yeah. This is coming from the legend. These are things I need to check out. Freaks.
Yeah, Todd Browning's Freaks is an old movie. It's like from the 30s.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but I tried watching it with my nieces one day, and they freaked out, man.
Really?
Yeah, the freaks all, they chant this, gibble gobble, gibble gobble, one of us, gibble gobble, one of us.
Oh, wow.
And it freaked my girls out.
Yeah.
Maybe Nosferatu, the original, the silent.
I've seen part of that, because it was silent, just my attention span just kind of.
How about Frankenstein?
I love that. The original with not Lon Chaney, Bela Lugosi.
Boris Karloff.
Boris Karloff, yes. Bela Lugosi was Dracula.
Yeah, Dracula.
Lon Chaney was Wolfman.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, trying to keep that all straight.
So those are some of the ones. Yeah. Here's an obscure title.
Mm-hmm.
Witchfinder General, a.k.a. The Conquer Worm.
The Conquer Worm.
Yeah. Or Witchfinder General.
Yeah.
It's a Vincent Price film.
Oh, he's great.
And it's about, you know, during the, what was it when the Reformation in England?
Mm-hmm.
And
I'm saying, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, I can't remember.
I don't know U.S. history, but, let alone English history.
Vincent Price plays a witch finder, and he goes around the countryside. This is like in the 1600s.
Mm-hmm.
And he has carte blanche to torture anybody he perceives to be a witch.
Oh, wow.
To prove that they're a witch.
Yeah.
You know? And in the end, there's a brutal scene when this soldier, who's in love with Vincent Price's main victim.
Yeah.
And in the end, the guy grabs a battle axe and just hacks Vincent Price to pieces.
Holy moly.
It's gruesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you like gore.
I love gore.
You're a big fan of gore.
Yeah.
See, I got a weak stomach. We talked about yesterday. Nine and I, before we even met each other, just in conversation, we realized that we both were at the midnight showing in, I think, 92? No,
97.
The midnight showing of Faces of Death at the Carmike or the Camelot Cinemas. When they quartered that guy, I can spoiler alert this one because it's 20 years old. They quartered that guy with horses. I ran out and threw my guts up in the bathroom. Anyway, he was at the same theater. We didn't even know each other then.
Oh, wow.
I have such a weak stomach, though. So gore, I can't watch gore. But just, like, I hear this music. They don't even do the music the same anymore. The lighting, I mean, that's what really sets it off to me, because I'll look away from the gore because I'll, you know, I watched an episode of Catfish one time. Girl popped her glass eye out. I passed out.
No way.
I literally fell to the ground in front of my wife who's sitting there laughing, thinking I'm joking.
You were unconscious.
I legit passed out.
Yep. I saw that in real life.
You look at the stomach, you think it'd be strong, but no. It's the opposite. So I can't watch the gore, but the music, the lighting, just people in a distance, like the little girls at the end of the hallway or Michael Myers at the end of a stairwell or anybody at the end of a hotel aisle or, in a hotel down the
that long corridor.
Like a corridor. Oh, my God. If it's bad lighting, if it's flickering, I used to could never go inside a church after dark. A church, of all places, would scare me.
Well, it's big and dark and cavernous and empty. It's kind of creepy.
But it's got to be the safest place on earth.
I know. Yeah. Makes no sense. I used to have horror movies or scary dreams about that.
I mean, I wrote a screenplay where the people take refuge in the church from the vampire bikers.
Wow. Vampire bikers. Yeah. Holy moly.
Yeah.
Wow. I see you have a belt with you. And that's not just any belt. I see our faces on that.
Yeah,
belt.
This is from Otis.
We knew you guys, huge wrestling fans.
Yes,
we wanted to bring. It's got the Monsters Fell and Be Champion on it.
Yes,
and we got y'all's faces on it.
Wow, look at
that. So we wanted you to have your own belt.
That is great.
We'll leave it down here in the off season.
Oh, and then whoever wins today will be able to hold it up in victory.
Yeah,
I see.
That's awesome. So, that's beautiful.
That is very nice. That's professional.
That looks really good.
So
that looks like the old WCW belt.
Yeah, that's the style I like.
Oh, Pinhead is trying to take the belt now. He's wanting to claim ownership of it.
There you go, man.
Oh, thank you, sir. Wow, this is not a replica, Jimmy. This is the heavy one.
I think he wants you to play it like a bass guitar.
Oh, you want me to play it like Hulk? Play it like a bass guitar? Well, that leads us into our next segment, then. It is time for the Fatboy third annual Monster Spelling Bee. It will be R.A. Mihailoff, the legendary, the real guy who was Leatherface in Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3. He's here. He's going to be appearing at Pinhead's Graveyard, 2099 National Highway in Canton, North Carolina. For more information, pinheadsgraveyard.com. He will be taking on Otis from Devil's Rejects, who will be taking on Pinhead from Hellraiser, who will be taking on Freddy from Nightmare on Elm Street.
Welcome to prime time, bitch!
We were playing the clip when you spelled macabre the other day.
M-C-C-O-B!
Well, you added an extra C. Last time it was just M-C-O-B. Yeah. But you're getting closer every year.
M-C-O-B.
There you go, M-C-O-B. There we go. All right, so here's what we'll do. When we come back, it will be the Monster Spelling Bee, and then we'll find out who is going to hold this golden belt that says 93.3, the Rise Guys Monster Spelling Bee Champion, and has all our faces on there. Who will it be?
That's cool, man.
Who's your money on, Jimmy?
Ah!
Who won last year? Does anybody remember? I remember.
Doesn't R.A. always win?
Fatboy, do you remember?
I think Otis won, didn't
I? Thought yeah. Otis won.
Otis won?
Otis won last year.
I'm still betting on R.A.
All right, so Otis, you hold the belt.
I'll do my best
belt,
nine.
And then you're going to defend it against these three men. This is a four-way dance.
Once I defend it, all the girls can come up here and ride Space Mountain.
Right. Very good. All right, when we come back, the Monster Spelling Bee. Leatherface versus Freddy versus Otis versus Pinhead, right after this.
The Rise Guys Morning Show, starring Mattman.
Nobody would question Michael Jordan if he said he was the best at basketball. I don't know why y'all looking at me like that. I'm good at sex.
Realizing I'm one of the last people who still likes The Simpsons don't make me feel old, but maybe kind of lame.
Age. I love these lyrics. Live fast, die young, fated to pretend. And that boy.
I try to get the fake pre-approved credit cards they send in the mail so my son can have a toy, and I can't even get those.
The Rise Guys.
Outrageous Morning Radio.
On 93.3, The Planet.
Here's Mattman. 9, Paige and Fatboy.
The Rise Guys Morning Show. 93.3 The Planet rocks.
Well, that's a different take on that.
A little bit.
Is that the Vitamin String Quartet?
Yep. I love their work.
There's this a band, is that what you would call them?
Group,
I guess. Group. They're all stringed instruments, and they take all these songs, it's not just themes, but they'll take rap songs and they'll turn it into, a string score. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I really like that. It's time for the Monster Spelling Bee. Prior to that, though, let me say who all's in here. We have, to my right is Freddy over by Paige. It's Otis from Devil's Rejects over in the corner, being very quiet and very eerie. Is Pinhead from Hellraiser. I have to keep looking. He's holding the chain up in the air now. Stop it. Stop that. I can't even look at him. And then to my left, the legend himself. I just saw the Saul. I just seen the Saul. I saw the Saul. What is it?
You saw the Saul. You saw the Saul.
Yeah. The Saul is across the hall. I got to get a picture with it. R.A. Mihailoff. The face behind Leatherface from Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3 is the actual guy is in studio with us. And one thing I was going to ask, Fatboy mentioned off the air, you were in the movie License to Drive.
Yes.
You were the guy that towed the car away.
The tow truck driver, yes.
Tow truck driver. Let me finish the question before you answer. Now that Full House is being Fuller House and they're revamping and rebooting that series, will you reprise your role of Tiny?
Excellent question, and I'd absolutely love to.
That would be awesome.
Yes, it
Everybody
would.
Everybody remembers Tiny from Full House. That was R.A. Mihailoff.
Tiny from Full House.
Leatherface was Tiny on Full House.
That's awesome.
Who knew? Thank God for the internet. Yeah, I couldn't even tell.
And Uncle Jesse stopped us from getting blood on the carpet.
Did he?
Well, yeah, that was the whole gag.
Yeah, he's the one that stopped you.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Tiny and Skull were going to do a headbutt.
Yeah.
And Uncle Jesse stepped in, tiny skull, you'll get blood on the carpet. And I go, oh, man.
You know, funny thing is, my kids, you know, with Nick at Night, they have watched Full House. And I ruined their lives about 6 months ago. They thought that was a new show. They did not know. Same thing with Fresh Prince. I was like, hey, look at the clothes. How do you not tell? So when I showed them a picture of the Olsen twins now, I could just see the look of just heartbreak in their face.
Really?
They were like, oh, no. Like, they felt sorry for the Olsen twins. I said, don't worry. They're like almost billionaires. They're doing okay.
Yeah, they're doing okay.
They're doing good. In fact, they said Uncle Jesse looks better now than he did then. You know?
It can happen.
Yeah, I told them to chill out. Don't be looking at him that way. The guys are in here today representing Pinhead's Graveyard, the big haunted attraction in Canton, 2099 Asheville Highway, Canton, North Carolina. Canton, for those of you who don't know, is right outside of Asheville, so it ain't too long of a drive if you're coming from the upstate. For more information, pinheadsgraveyard.com. And we've got some passes we'll do with the TSL question of the day today, so you can go check it out. VIP, too.
Yes.
Your own Otis's guest.
Authorized
list.
By Otis.
Authorized by Otis. That's right. Okay. So, correct me if I'm wrong, Jim. The way we do this is, do I say the word and then they scream their name if they want to guess it?
I believe that's how we do it.
Okay. And we're doing best of seven.
Yes.
Okay.
Ish.
I have to, seven-ish.
I got a couple more if you need them.
Okay, we'll pass those on, because if it gets good, we need to roll with it. Oh, I don't even know what that last one is. You hold it. If we get to that, you can do it, because I don't know what that says.
That's fine.
Okay, I have to guard, because I've got monsters all over the place. I don't want anybody to.
You got monsters on all sides.
Not that anybody would cheat. Okay, now,
Freddy. Quit it, Freddy.
Freddy's cheating. Okay, here we go. Word number one in the 2015 Monster Spelling Bee is cemetery.
Cemetery?
Pinhead's up first.
Pinhead raised his hand first. You don't talk, though. Will you speak? He's just holding. Yeah, oh, he's doing it with his finger. C.
E.
Yeah.
M.
Yeah.
E.
Right.
C.
Was that a what? Say it again.
C.
Yes.
A. R. Y.
That is incorrect. And don't be mad at me. This is not. It's not correct. Anyone for the steal? The word is
Freddy.
Cemetery. Freddy.
G-R-A-V-E-Y-A-R-D.
How did he spell it? I can't even keep up.
I believe that was graveyard, man.
Graveyard. Oh. Close. Right.
I've got it.
Close.
I've got it.
The synonym game will win with that.
I'm going to try.
Go for it. R.A. Mihailoff.
C-E-M-E-N. T-A-R-Y.
That's also incorrect. I'm so sorry.
All right, Otis.
Otis?
Let's see. C-E-M-E-T-A-R-Y?
Say it one more time.
C-E-M-E-T-A-R-Y?
That's incorrect. Also. Is there anyone left?
I want to sweet talk Paige and get her to pull it up on Google for me.
Everybody's guessed, correct?
Everybody went, yes.
Nine, tell them how to spell cemetery. Cemetery, whatever it is.
Correctly, C-E-M-E-T-E-R-Y.
Right. There's an E, yeah. Don't worry about it. That's one of those words that they always put on lists that people commonly misspell.
Well, so. Dude, I didn't figure out how to spell that word until probably this morning because Stephen King was a dick all those years.
What's the correct spelling?
C-E-M-E-T-E-R-Y. Cemetery. Yes. What, did Stephen King misspell it?
Pet Cemetery.
Pet Cemetery.
Started with an S.
Ah, yes.
S-E-M.
So it's all E's.
It is all E's. Always remember that, right.
Okay. Well, at least we learned something on this round.
That's right. It's educational, the Monster Spelling Bee is. All right, here we go. Word number two, the 2015 Monster Spelling Bee. It's Leatherface versus Freddy versus Pinhead versus Otis. Word number two, obituary. Obituary. Oh, I can't wait to hear Freddy on this one.
I got it.
Who said that? Was that R.A.?
Yeah, that would be me.
Okay, R.A. Spell obituary.
O-B-I-T-U-A-R-Y.
That is correct.
Bing, 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 bing,
R-A
bing.
R.A. with a point.
Yeah!
Yes, yes.
Yay!
That's awesome. Who's keeping score?
I got score so
Nine's
far.
Nine's keeping score. Okay, R.A. Leatherface in the lead with one. All right. All right, Freddy, let's get in the game now.
Wake up, Freddy. Face, I'm waiting on you, Mattman.
All right, here we go. Word number three, 2015, Rise Guy's Monster Spelling Bee is crematory. Crematory.
Freddy.
Freddy?
C-R-E-A-M-O-T-O-R-Y.
That
correct.
Yeah, I apologize.
You got the buzzer. All right, Otis.
I just found the buzzer. That's why. Otis, go ahead. Crematory.
C-R-E-M-E-T-O-R-Y.
Also
correct. You got the buzzer.
Everybody's getting buzzed today. Crematory. Now, one thing I'll tell you is R.A. Mihailoff, he actually he writes it down, and it helps him to spell it out.
It's much easier to write it down.
Pinhead, you want to give it a go or no? He's good. He's shaking his head no. He's okay. He's
all right, I'll give it a try. I think I'm wrong, but I'll give it a try.
No, never. You know, think positive. You got this.
Well, I am positive, but this doesn't look right, but...
Fatboy's hepatitis B positive.
All right, you know what? Here we go. I'm taking a lesson learned from cemetery.
Okay, yes.
C-R-E-M-E-T-O-R-Y.
I'm sorry. So sorry. Otis, you want to give it a try or no? No? We good?
Otis tried it.
Oh, Otis tried. Who did it? Everybody tried it.
Hey, everybody but Pinhead's tried it. Pinhead said he's good.
Nine. Do you know?
It's C-R-E-M-A-T-O-R-Y.
That's right.
Oh,
crema.
Well, it's like the opposite of cemetery.
I know.
That's what
I know.
Oh, I overthought it.
That's what I had originally.
It's Matt doing dirty because he put cemetery before crematory.
Yeah.
Cemetery don't make sense, and then crematory does.
Listen, don't be trying to get me stabbed or chainsawed or whatever. Poke in the head.
Might put you in a headlock here in a minute.
Watch out, Freddy. Good Lord. No matter how you meant it, I don't like it either way. Okay, here we go. Monster Spelling Bee. What's the score? Still 1-0?
1-0.
1-0, nothing, nothing?
No, R.A. got one. So that's R.A.'s up 1-0.
Yeah,
1-0.
Would have been 2.
All right, here we go. The next word. I'm going to tell you, this will be a toughie. I had to look it up. Massacre.
I got it.
Okay, R.A., without even writing it down.
M-A-S-S-A-C-R-E.
That's correct. That's correct.
How many times do you think I've written that down?
Well, I was going to say, that should be in your wheelhouse. That's right. Massacre.
So that's 2 for R.A.
That's right.
And so far, nobody else has any.
R.A. may win this.
We got to step our game up.
Debuting title belt.
I want that gold strap, brother. I want that gold strap.
All right, here we go.
What else you got, man?
All right, here we go. Word number, whatever it is. 5? Is that what we're on? Number 5?
Something like that.
Is apparition.
Freddy.
Freddy.
APPERATION.
Correct, Frederick.
Otis.
Otis?
APPARITION.
That is correct.
Yes.
That is correct. Otis is on the board with 1. Fantastic.
Space Mountain's opening up for business, R.A.
Oh, Lord.
If R.A. gets another one, he definitely wins.
Why? If you want to end the game, I guess.
But, I mean, he definitely would win with 1 more.
Okay. Technicality.
Technicality, yeah. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you and tell you I get 2 more words.
By the way, I did have apparition right.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay. Congratulations.
I was just a little slow on the buzzer.
Understand. All right, so I still want to do the last 2, but regardless, yes, R.A. can win if he gets it.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, let's do them all.
So for good radio, R.A., don't get this one right. Okay. All right, here we go. Word number 6 in the Rise Guys 2015 Monster Spelling Bee, Phantasm.
Freddy? Phantasum.
Close. Otis.
Straight me.
Uh-oh.
You got to say your name.
You do?
I'm going out on technicality here.
All right. Go ahead.
Phantasm.
That is correct.
You stumped me on that.
Oh, okay. Lord. I just saw R.A. give Otis a look, too, like,
He was going to stab me.
You just stepped on my toes.
I know, right?
I'm going to saw you now.
Did you feel?
No. I didn't know you had to say your name. I thought you just had to speak
Would
up.
Would past okay. tense be you got chain scene?
Chain scene.
English is so difficult.
Chain
no
scene.
Wonder the Mexicans don't bother to learn it.
What?
It's so hard. I'm from here and don't know how to say it all. The English language.
Oh, yeah.
It should be chain scene.
Yeah.
It's chainsaw.
Chain scene, not chainsaw.
I would have got Phantasm wrong anyway.
Okay. Why? How'd you spell it?
With an F.
Oh. And look.
Like a fantasy?
Yeah. Right. Like fantastic.
So here's where we are. Freddy and Pinhead don't have a chance. But still try, because that's fun.
It's college effort here. Come on.
College? Don't you mean elementary effort?
Well.
Hey. Here we go.
There's effort regardless.
The last and final word of this year's Monster Spelling Bee.
What is it?
Unless we have to do a tiebreaker.
Or a neckbreaker.
Is Spalding.
Freddy.
Freddy, as in Captain Spalding.
Wait.
S-P-A-L-D-I-N-G.
So I got close. It. R-A has it.
R-A, as in Captain Spalding from Devil's Rejects. Here we go.
S-P-A-U-L-D-I-N-G.
Yes! We have a winner! We have a winner!
Yeah!
Leatherface! Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
I got the first handshake from the champion. Take that back. Now, you have to present the belt to him.
Oh, man.
You have to concede the title. The big celebration. The changing of guard. That's right. Hold on. I want to have a picture to show my grandkids one day. Here we go.
Give me that strap, brother.
It pains me to do this.
Give me that strap,
there
brother.
There it is.
The gold is mine.
The exchanging of the belt right there. Wow. He is now champion. The Rise Guys 2015 Monster Spelling Bee Champion. R.A. Speech.
I'd like to thank the thousands in attendance and the millions listening at home.
Right.
I have to say that...
Let's get this man some cough syrup. Go ahead.
I'm choked up. Yes. I'm literally choked up by this...
sentimental moment.
...event.
Yes.
This is a great honor.
Yes.
This is a beautiful belt.
It's lovely.
I will wear it with honor.
Yes.
I will represent 93.3.
Yes.
Everywhere I go.
Thank you.
And if I lose next year, I will gracefully relinquish. But I ain't going to lose, brother.
That's right. You know, all-time champion. That's the way I see it happening. Now, when folks come up to Pinhead's graveyard up in Kenton, will they be able to see the title? Will they be able to see the belt?
We could bring it up there, yeah.
I imagine people want to get a picture with the belt also.
Yeah.
That's
let's
a premium charge.
We could do that.
That's an extra fee.
Okay. It's a premium item. You're right.
All right.
You've been to enough independent wrestling shows that you know belt and the Polaroid cost more.
Independent wrestlers keep Polaroid in business. That's the only reason they make the film anymore.
we'll have it up there Thursday, starting tonight through Sunday.
No extra charge, though, for getting a selfie with the belt.
That's right. Exactly. All right. Boy, this was fun. I tell you, each year it gets more and more fun. Freddie, it was our honor. Thank you.
It was all my pleasure.
Your tongue is pierced.
It is.
That's great.
Freddie has pierced tongue.
Pinhead, thumbs up from him. He's pointing at me. Yeah. He's pointing at nine over here.
You ain't going to say nothing about his piercings?
Well, I mean, that's evident.
Pinhead's face is pierced. You going to give me a little bit of crap about my tongue?
No, I was just saying. I don't give any crap. I just noticed it.
Pinhead's got dermals.
I didn't know that. I thought you had a ball bearing on your mouth for a minute. That's a piercing.
You got any other piercings, Freddie?
Yeah, I've got several, but I can't show you here.
Well, where are we going? Otis? Thank you, sir.
We appreciate it, as always.
Always a pleasure. And then the legend. I mean, I can now, I tell my kids, I know horror movie royalty.
Mm-hmm. And I just tell people I know Leatherface.
I know. R.A. Mihailoff, pleasure, sir. Every year, it's always so much fun.
Mattman, thank you. It is a blast coming down here. It's almost, it's a tradition, isn't it?
It is. We'll do the fourth annual next year, God willing. It'll be fun.
God willing and the creek don't rise.
That's right. All right, very good. We'll take a break. We'll be back right after this.
Follow the Rise Guys on Twitter at 933theplanet. Tweet that. This is the Rise Guys Morning Show.
93.3 The Planet. Just rocks.
Rise Guys Morning Show. Good morning to you. It is, 9/11. Fantastic.
Yeah.
That was a whole lot of fun. Those guys are awesome. To be so scary looking, they're all freaking awesome.
Sure was.
And, we got pictures with Leatherface and the actual Saul. What does the Saul say?
The Saul is family.
Saul is family.
That is the tagline from Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3.
Yes, the Saul is family. That was a whole lot of fun. Again, back to that. Those guys, I'll tell you, what... R.A. Mihailoff, what a good dude.
I enjoy his annual visit to the upstate in Western North Carolina.
Yeah. He's like Steve-O in that just when you meet him, just so nice.
Mm-hmm.
Just so nice. I mean, I'm sure somebody out there don't like him.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure somebody out there has a problem with R.A., but
yeah.
None of us do.
God, what a...
You won't tell him to his face?
No, you won't.
That's what Fatboy was saying. Like, he shook hands with him, and in the picture, like, his hand is just, like, swallowing up Fatboy's hand.
Yeah. I couldn't see it.
It's crazy, crazy, crazy.
It's a large individual, man.
Yeah. Thanks to R.A. Mihailoff, the face, the legend behind Leatherface in Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3, for coming in today along with Freddy, Otis, and Pinhead. We do appreciate that. That was fun.
And now, Nine's TSL question of the day.
R.A. Mihailoff played Tiny on what 90s TV show? You heard that earlier this morning. Text the answer to the Carolina Vapor Mill text line. 72341 is the number. 93rd correct answer wins.
93-minute nonstop Rob Block going to kick off next. Paige rocking you at work. $1,000 at 11 o'clock. The P1 payoff. Fat Boy tomorrow morning, 5 a.m. Rise Guys Rewind. We'll go live at 6. Thanks so much for listening. Have a blessed day. Tickle it, guys.
Outrageous Morning Radio with the Rise Guys. 93.3 The Planet.
Your suffering will be legendary, even in hell.